Good morning, praise the Lord, and welcome once again. This morning, I've taken my text from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 5, verse 1 to 12 and 11. And we will look at the characteristics very briefly of the life of Peter. And originally, he is called Simon. His name was Simon, and in Matthew chapter 13, verse 2, Mark chapter 3, verse 16, talks about him. He was a brother of Andrew, and he was a fisherman. The meaning of the word Simon is reed. And as we know, the reed, what does the reed do? It can be blown around by the wind. It can bend down. When there is a flow of water or trade wind, it bends down. And it can be tossed around. So that's the character that Peter had. But Christ changed him to be a great apostle that we know today. So we see that Christ called this reed or Simon Cephas. That means Peter, and that the word Cephas means rock. John chapter 1 verse 42, there he, Christ, changed his name. But let's come back to where I would like to start my message. It says that Jesus, in Luke chapter 5, Jesus was by the lake of Gennesaret, and he was teaching the people on the shore of the lake, and there were two boats, and fishermen were washing their nets. And Jesus, because of the crowd, got on one of the boats, which was Simon's boat, and taught the people from the boat about the kingdom of God, about God. And then he turns around to Simon, and this is what Christ says in verse 4, chapter 5, Luke chapter 5, verse 4. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, put out into deep water and let down the net for a catch. Simon answered, Master, we have worked hard all night and haven't caught anything, but because you say so, I will let down the nets. Yes, Christ tells him, after teaching, I finished, he said, okay, put your boat into deep waters, come. Let's go one furlong ahead and put out your nets. Simon, an expert fisherman, said, Oh Lord, you know, we have worked all night and we haven't caught anything. No fish. But nevertheless, because you are saying so, I will put out my net. Now, let's look in between the lines. Christ said, put out your nets. Lay down the nets for a catch. And here, Peter says, I will let down the nets. He decided to do that. When you and I first look at and seek after God and God's will in our life, God blesses us. Remember, God is not your debtor. If he takes something for you, he gives from you, he gives you a blessing. He used Peter's boat and he blessed him. And what happened? When Peter threw his net out, you know what happened? They got a great catch of fish. Blessing in abundance. You see, he was in a way trying to tell Christ, what do you know about fishing, Lord? You are a rabbi, you are a teacher. I am an expert fisherman. He was trying to question and teach the Creator, the God who created the seas and everything in it. He was trying to teach. And that God said, let down your nets. You and I need to let down our nets. When God says to share the word of God, you and I need to share the word of God with the lost generation of today. We need to do that. And when we do that, what happens? Our nets are full. We catch many fish. They caught so much that Peter and his companions had to signal to John and James, sons of Zebedee, come with your net. And both the nets were filled. When God does a miracle in your life and my life, what happens? It's full and overflowing. You know, it amazes me. So much of fish they caught that the two boats were filled and yet the net did not tear. When God blesses us, we will not be torn apart. We will be full of blessings and God will help give us a great victory. Now, what was the secret behind Peter's life? Peter confessed and repented. He confessed Christ and he said, I am a sinner, Lord. I am a sinner. Peter confessed that I am a sinner and repented. Look at verse 8. He says, when Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' feet and said, go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man. You and I need to confess with our mouth that we are sinners and Christ will save us and repent of our sins. We need to repent of our sins and then Christ will save us. They were amazed when God does the work. We will be amazed by the work of God in our life, in our work, in our family, in our churches. He will do a work. You know what? Peter followed Christ everywhere Christ went. After this, what happened? In verse number 10, I would let it for. And so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee. They were all astonished at what had taken place, how much of the fish they had caught. Then Jesus said to Simon, don't be afraid. From now on, you will catch men. So they left. They pulled their boats up on shore and left everything and followed him. When Christ calls us, he calls us publicly and he expects that we should leave all that we are doing and live by him. They left everything, they left their profession and followed him. So Peter followed Christ, as I read for you in Luke chapter 5 verse 11. And then Peter saw miracles that Jesus performed. Yes, Peter saw so many miracles that Christ performed because he was with Christ all the time, moving around with Christ. In fact, Matthew chapter 8 verse 14-15 records that Jesus went into Peter's house and he found Peter's mother-in-law was sick with fever. Jesus touched her by hand and the fever left and she started to wait upon the Lord. And not only that, but further the same day, if you read verse number 16 and 17, it talks many people were healed. Many people came with their sickness an evil spirit. Jesus cast out the evil spirit and they were healed. Christ, He is the healer. And Peter knew that very well. Peter knew that Christ would heal. Peter had total confidence and faith in Christ. He walked on the water. He confessed Christ's deity. Yes, in the book of Matthew chapter 14, verse number 26 to 29, we see that Jesus came walking on the water and Peter said, "Lord, if it is you, can I come?" And Peter said, Jesus said, "Peter, come in." And Peter stepped out of the boat and walked on the water towards Christ. And he walked till he, as long as he had his eyes on Christ, he walked till he was not distracted. When he saw the wind and saw the waves, he was distracted and started to sing. When you and I walk in the ways of the Lord and fix our eyes on the author and finisher of our faith, that is Jesus Christ, we will never fall, we will never fail. God will provide a miracle for us. Then, in another occasion, in Matthew chapter 16, Christ asked his disciples, "Who do people say I am?" They answered and said, "Some say you are a prophet, some say you are John the Baptist, so others say you are a man of God." And Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do you say I am?" And then Peter spoke up and said, "You are the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of God." He confessed the deity of Christ, that Christ is the Son of God. That is Matthew chapter 16, verse 16 to 18. If you read, you'll find he said that. We see that Christ said to him, "Upon this rock, upon this confession, I will build my church." Do we have the confession of Christ like Peter's? Do we recognize the deity of Christ or not? In your life, in my life, in your family and my family, in our church, are we preaching the Christ resurrected and the deity of Christ or not? That's what matters in our life. You know what? Peter's experience, I'm sharing this with the part of his experience. What Peter had? Peter walked with Christ. Peter saw the miracles. Peter confessed Christ. Peter experienced the miracle of walking in the water. And then Peter saw the transfiguration of Christ. He saw the transfiguration of Christ in Matthew chapter 17, verse 1 to 8. When Christ took Peter, James and John on a mountain and he was transfigured, there again Peter opens his mouth and says, "It is good for us, Lord, that we are here. We will build three tabernacles." But the voice from the cloud said, from the sky said, "What? This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." Peter saw the transfiguration of Christ. His countenance had changed. His robe was as white as snow. Christ! You know what? Peter was a man who denied Christ. Yes, three times. That's his experience in life. But when he realized, he cried out to Christ. He cried bitterly for the mistake that he had made. Matthew 26, verse 75. And then he went back to fishing. After staying for 3.5 years with Christ, after the... Yes, Peter went back to fishing. John chapter 21, verse 1 to 14. But Christ reinstated Peter Okay, but he was reinstated by Christ. Peter was given back his position. And then Christ said to Peter over here, Peter, do you love me more than this? Peter said, no, Lord, I love you. And this same question was repeated 3 times. And Christ said, all 3 times, feed my sheep, feed my lamb, fish, feed my sheep. And then Peter received the Holy Spirit. And he became bold. Peter received the Holy Spirit and became bold. Acts chapter 2 verse 1 to 41. Yes, on this day, after he received the Holy Spirit, he stood up and preached the mighty sermon. He preached a great sermon. And on that same day, when he explained the coming of the Holy Spirit and preached the sermon, 3,000 people were added to the whole. Yes, 3,000 people accepted Christ on the day of Pentecost when he preached the sermon. Yes, this is the great work that Peter did. A man who was Simon, a reed, who could be moved around, became a rock and solid rock for Christ. And he preached a great sermon and people were saved. In Acts chapter 3, verse 1 to 11, we see that Peter and John were going up to the temple, and there the Lord used him to heal the man born lame. To heal the lame man, the lame beggar over there at the gate called Beautiful. Yes. He stood before the synagogue and Sanhedrin and spoke boldly for Christ. Even the Sanhedrin had to admit that Peter was an educated fisherman and he had been with Christ. That's how bold he was. Acts chapter 4 verse 1 to 22. You see that? We need to understand that we can live a life for Christ, follow him the way Peter followed him, left everything for Christ and followed him. He received the power of the Holy Ghost, and you and I need to receive the power of the Holy Ghost, and then we can follow Christ and live for him and win souls. For Christ, we like a Peter. The Lord has given us the great commission. Go into the world and preach the gospel. Are you a Peter or a Simon? What are you? The Lord expects to use you. Lord wants to use you for his kingdom. Lord wants to use you for his kingdom. He wants to make you into a rock solid believer for Christ. Are you willing to accept him as Lord and Savior? Are you willing to confess him and repent from your sin like Peter did? Are we willing to feed the sheep that Lord has entrusted us with? That's what it is. We should confess the deity of Christ. Are we willing to do it? Where do you stand today? If Christ comes today, where do you and I stand? Are we Simon or Reed, or are we in Peter, a solid rock for Christ and winning souls for him? Decide for yourself what you want to be. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you and praise you. Morning, Lord, for your grace which is sufficient for us. Lord, help us to confess you as Lord and Savior, Lord. Help us to see the good things that you do for us each day, Lord. The miracles that you perform in our lives each moment, O God. Lord, help us to take a stand for you. To share the word boldly, O Father. Lord, help us to confess you, Lord. And repent from our ways and live for you. In Jesus' holy, precious name we pray. Amen. God bless you.